I barely slept while we were on the train. My thoughts kept me awake with a burning fever to see our new home. My wife Hildred and I decided to move suddenly. She hurriedly packed our luggage, taking only what was strictly necessary. We cut a good deal buying this place near the river, which had previously been owned by a well-known barber in the town.
This house is surprisingly large. There's enough space on the ground floor to turn it into a beautiful pub, while downstairs in the basement there's already a large, cozy kitchen. I can't wait to get to know my new customers. I've always enjoyed watching people eating the meals I've cooked for them lovingly. My husband, Percival, has cleaned the first floor and set his room up for business. A fancy tailor shop. It won't be long before we see the women from the local district showing off the beautiful outfits he has made for them. We are going to bring home the gold with our business.
You may wonder what the secret behind our success is. Our loyal clients, obviously. Fantastic people. I feel kind of sorry about killing them. We've decided to use an unusual ingredient in our specialties. As a result of the insanely high meat prices, due to sheer hunger, or simply because it tastes so delicious, human flesh is highly appreciated. We do not know the reason why, and we don't really care.
But don't worry. We don't waste anything. Even their clothes are cleverly reused by Percival. They just need a little patching up, and then they are ready for sale again. At full price, of course. We are working so damn hard to do things right and earn as much money as we can. I should clean this from time to time. Baking time. People will like this. letter just arrived. We moved here not long ago. No one should know us. Who may have sent this? Did you tell anyone about our departure?
Silence! Let me read. God! Someone knows our secret.
Thank you.
Time will do its job. At least they're not rotten.
The best ingredients for my recipes.
Thank you. Thank you.
must wait. Mr. J has finally arrived. He immediately made it clear that we would have our reward at the end of the meal. Tonight, I have outdone myself on the cooking front. The main dish is Gilbert, served rare with salt and pepper. Lady LaRoche is only skin and bones. I put her on the stove to avoid scorching the skin. Elliot has been here for a while. In fact, he smelt awful, but I still did a great job. I put his eyes in the pan with some sugar to caramelize them. Mmm, such a scrumptious dessert. Mr. J seemed to enjoy his meal. He ate it as if he was starving. It was quite disgusting.
The reward he offered us for our hard work? Just more bother. He requests that we become his personal chefs in return for his protection. Surely that would have made us untouchable, but also his slaves. We understood that he wasn't prepared to take no for an answer. We are no longer willing to play his games. The only thing that he will taste now are my scissors.
Watch out!